Hi everyone, and welcome to Write, Learn and Earn, where you're going to learn different skills that are going to help you to launch your author career or to take your author career to the next level. So how many of you have felt that the pandemic is a little bit overwhelming? Oh, definitely me. But I still had to write. And the circumstances at our home is that my husband and I each have a computer. My computer is over the hill. I think that Noah brought it out his first edition with the Arc. And then we've got two young children that are homeschooling, an 8-year-old and a 6-year-old. And we've all got to use those computers. So I still had to write. I still had to launch my author career. And this year I did 2 books and 1 short story. And I still kind of feel like I'm treading on water, that I still need to get ahead. So I've had to look at a whole bunch of different ways to get things done. And one of the ways that you can work faster is to do dictation. Now, I've had a little bit of experience of dictation in the past, but today we're going to work a bit with Google Docs as voice dictation, and just have a look and see what it looks like on the computer and how it's going to work. I have downloaded it onto my phone, so I have tried out a couple of times. It's a little bit flaky. I'm still trying to learn how to do things, but today I'm going to do a demo with you on the computer that you can see what happens with Google Docs and how we work it. I just have to let you know that if you've got strange characters' names like I do, I've got Muquin and Megaduce and a couple of very interesting characters, and some of the names are just completely alien to the dictation software. So what I have to do is I have to call them something simple like Dragon C or Dragon D, and then go and do a search later on and do the changes. So I'm going to do a share screen now so that you can have a look at Google Docs and then see how that works. And I'm not going to be doing brand new work. What I'm going to do is read from one of my existing books. That way we can get through it quicker instead of me having to think up new content to put in over here. So let's shoot over to Google Docs quickly. Okay, so we're going to go to my desktop. Right. So once you've got Google open, then you're going to go to Tools. Now this looks a little bit different on the phone. Because on the phone, you are going to go into your keyboard and that's going to give you the voice option. But here we're going to go to voice typing. And the theory is, which we're going to be testing, is that when I click this button, it's going to type out everything that I say or I read. So let's head over to my book, The Last of the Silver Wings, and we're going to click to speak. The villagers had been trapped in the tunnel for days. Full stop. The gnawing hunger in Judas's belly consumed his mind. Full stop. He had watched how mothers had daily fed their loathsome children tiny slithers of the dried meat that the girl had divided amongst them. Full stop. New paragraph. He swallowed hard to fight against his rising nausea. Full stop. if he could just find something to eat, how much longer would they be in this miserable hole for? Question mark. New line. The children of the three so-called leaders of this pathetic pack seemed none the worse for wear to his mind. Full stop. Okay, so let's have a look at that. So it's didn't say villagers. So I had to edit that out. And then I was supposed to say capital T. The gnawing hunger in Judas's. Okay, so instead of doing Judas's, it's gone there. And it wasn't barely, it was Billy. Okay, Billy. So gotta take that out. Okay, he consumed his mind, and we've got to put our capitals. So the capitals are actually a command that I should have put in, but I didn't put in. This somehow came onto a capital when it wasn't supposed to be a capital. And this was supposed to be a hole. and I didn't put a comma in over there. So Google Docs is helping me to make some of these corrections. Okay. Now I'm going to do a little test and see what happens if I say things very quickly. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to do the part of this tutorial just speaking straight into it without reading so I can go quicker. Okay, so now we're going to test how fast Google Docs can actually type. Can it type in tune to my voice? So for this part of the tutorial, I'm not going to be doing any of the full stop, exclamation mark, question mark, new line. I'm not going to do that in the correct way, but we are going to see if Google Docs can keep up with my voice, because some people think much faster or speak much faster than what we imagine this can go for. So I'm going to speak about things that are happening in my life at the moment and just see how quickly Google Docs can catch up with me. So a day in the life of an author. This morning I woke up and it was 1 o'clock in the morning. I was struggling to sleep. My eldest daughter is doing a sleep science course at the moment. So I would definitely be in one of those red flag places to say that I have a proper sleep problem and I either need sleep therapy or I need to be medically treated. But instead of worrying about things, I work. Yes, I may be a workaholic, and yes, it may not be a good thing for the health of my heart, but I certainly get more things done than lying in bed fretting about what could be or what hasn't happened or what should be. So we are going to take a pause from my nattering and see how Google Docs has performed. And it's still going. So I've switched off the dictation tool and it's still going. Let's see if it gets to where. Ooh, it actually looks like someone else is typing over there. Isn't technology fabulous? I think it's doing an exceptionally good catch-up job. I really have to say I'm quite impressed. Now, obviously, I'm going to have to edit this because it's not yet learned the sound of my voice. But you can see over here that it's done the full stop. It has done the exclamation mark and the question mark that I used in my normal sentence, and it's still going. So this reminds me of the book that Terry Pratchett wrote called Making Movies, where they had all these little imps inside the camera and they were painting all the pictures that they saw. So this feels like it's a little imp inside Google Docs that is typing out all of the words that I have used. It's actually pretty cool. Okay, so it seems to have paused itself, but if you have a look at how much it's done, I'm actually incredibly impressed with what I've been able to type in the dictation. So let's stop the share screen so that you can see my face again. I have to say I am really impressed with what it was able to do. And it certainly can keep up with my voice. I cannot type as fast as what I can speak. The challenge is, does it have enough accuracy? Well, I have tried other software beforehand, and I've tend to abandon most of them, but this one, I must say, has been quite helpful. It takes minimal editing, and once you know some of the rules, it can actually help a lot. So I learned about dictation when I was watching another educational series of videos that Mark Dawson puts together. And there was a lady who had said that she developed breast cancer, and she had to go for a lot of treatments, and then typing on the computer, moving her hands forward, caused a lot of discomfort for her. And so she actually physically couldn't type. So she used a dictation software and she produced most of her books that way. And then she just would work on editing. So that's why I thought that I would give it a bash. And I must say that I'm quite impressed with how the software has performed. So if you do have a medical condition, or you maybe have issues with your spine or your back that prevents you from spending a lot of time in front of the computer, I would say give it a bash at this one. What I have learned is that it does sometimes take time to get accustomed to the sound of your voice and how you say certain things, but a lot of the bots can actually learn what the words are, and some of the software has got an option to teach it certain kinds of words. So I hope that you found this tutorial very helpful to you, and do try it out on your phone. I haven't yet got as much success on my phone as what I've had on the computer, but I think that could be because of the quality of my phone. I have dropped it a few times, and so it does, it is a bit flaky at times. So you might find that if you have a better quality phone, that it's going to work well for you. So let me know in the comment section if you have used dictation software beforehand, and what works well for you. And also, please do subscribe to the video that you can see more videos of this nature. And let me know if there's something that you would like me to do a video on. So until next time, have a fabulous day and keep those words coming. Bye for now.